Powerhouse center has a nice ring to it, but it really means the whole region too. And it means we're talking the environmental aspects, we're talking about the river, the water, the scientific aspects, and quite frankly, you think about Ducks Unlimited, and their contribution is absolutely wonderful because it shows a real partnership here between the ducks people, the wildlife people, we have the farmers, we've got the business people, we've got the scientists, engineers, and teachers, and they're all our focus here along this
I'm Congressman John Garamendi. Over the years, I've had the privilege of representing much of California's wetlands, the marshes, this incredible riparian habitat. For 75 years, Ducks Unlimited has made this part of America and part of California.
San Francisco Bay just got a little bit bigger, and so did the habitat for several endangered species in the process. As ABC 7's Jonathan Bloom reports, a little digging is reversing decades of damage to the Bay Area's coastline.
In an instant, the bay water that was held back for years rushes in, and nature does the rest.
Move the levees out of the way and let the tide water come back in, and that's the magic ingredient. The tide water has the mud in it, it's got the seeds in it, and it just kind of takes care of itself.
But I want to single out Ducks Unlimited because we hear about them for their engineering, and we hear about them and their funding, and we hear about them as a great contributor to waterfowl because of their name, Ducks Unlimited. But they are really about wetlands and habitat, and they are about leadership. So their role is so essential in conservation across our landscape. We are privileged to have worked with them here.
And what I learned this morning and what your kids can learn, Aaron was teaching me that not all duck sounds are the same.
That's correct.
I thought that was it. I thought that was the call for everything. But
a little more range.
So you've got your little quackers here, and you've been trying to teach them stuff. Can you teach us like one call real quick? One call, like
sure,
you were showing.
Sure. Let's do a little single call.
Okay.
It's
like you're hooting.
Hood.
You guys ready? Hood. Okay. So what am I saying there if I was a duck?
Just saying, hey, I'm hanging out. We're just hanging
That's
out with
an
the
anniversary
kids.
Without a giant cake. Look at this. They brought his cake.
We've got cake.
Thank you very much, guys. All right, well, head on down to Galt, and it's going to be a great time for everybody, or as the ducks say.
The Ducks Unlimited group was also at the Snow Goose Festival to celebrate a huge milestone. Today marks 75 years of wetlands conservation. Ducks Unlimited is the world's largest nonprofit organization, which restores and enhances wetlands throughout North America to keep refuges available for wildlife and waterfowl. A cake big enough to feed a flock was offered up to guests today.
The work that Ducks Unlimited is doing on the ground right now benefits everybody, not only the waterfowl, the wildlife, everything, but it's going to benefit generations to come. And that's really the whole purpose of why Ducks Unlimited does the works that it does.
Ducks Unlimited has conserved more than 12 million acres of wetland since the group was established in 1937.
50-year-old dirt bridge is now gone. Now a rail car bridge replaces it, helping farmers and wildlife around Elk Grove.
Now the bridge is secured over a slough that connects the North and South Stone Lakes near I-5 and Hood Franklin Road. Kristen Marshall has the details.
Just 3 weeks ago, wildlife in this waterway was suffocating under all of this green. Now it's thriving thanks to a new type of green.
They're recycled rail cars that we've salvaged and modified to work as a bridge application.
100,000-pound rail car flats hoisted into place by the Paul Bunyan of Cranes. and secured over the slough that connects the North and South Stone Lakes near I-5 and Hood Franklin Road. The bridge will finally restore both farmer access to the fields and passage for wildlife and boaters underneath after the old dirt bridge cut off natural water flow for nearly 50 years. Using repurposed rail cars like this instead of concrete helped turn this project from a multi-million dollar project into about a $250,000 project funded mostly by taxpayers.
All right, like the hard hat.